Yeah, in this fifth video, we are going to talk about indexing again. However, unlike the first video where we talked about indexing, we will be talking about advanced indexing now. So we will introduce some topics like memory views and creating memory copies and so forth, which I think is very important in practice because that avoids, or knowing about it avoids making mistakes like accidentally overwriting certain array values when it's not intended that you do that. So yeah, I think this is maybe one of the most important videos about NumPy because it really helps avoiding unwanted bugs and weird behavior in NumPy. So yeah, let's get started. Yes, so in the previous section, like I'm writing here, is one aspect about it is that we created so-called views of NumPy arrays in memory. So when we were using the regular, the basic indexing, we were creating views, not copies of arrays. And this can be sometimes a little bit dangerous because we can accidentally overwrite values if we are not aware of it. So consider the simple example here where I have an array, a two-dimensional array, two rows, three columns. And just for my convenience, I'm assigning a new variable here, or I'm assigning the first row to this first row variable. Let me just do this in a separate step here. It's maybe easier to explain it this way. So first row will be the vector or one-dimensional array 1, 2, 3 now. And so we just assigned this one to this variable. However, in contrast to certain other parts of Python and how they behave, this created a view onto this array. So what that means is that this is actually not its own object. This is just a link to this original part in the array. So if I now execute this row here, which means adding the number 99 to every value in this variable here, what will happen is it will overwrite the original value as well. So let's take a look what I mean by that. We execute this, now, and you can see an array. So what happens is first row will be all incremented by 99, but array as well. So we not only modified the values in this variable here, but we also modified the first row in the original array. So that is kind of like a hint that what we were working with is just a view onto this, onto these values in memory. It's not like its own object. And not knowing about this can be a little bit dangerous because you can now see it may be easy to overwrite certain values if we work with, let's say, the array, but in the meantime, for convenience, we create a variable, which is just the first row or some other value in that array, and we maybe want to increment it as a type of counter or something like that. We may do that, and then by accident, we forget that this also modifies the original array, and then we get into trouble if we want to use the original array for some computations later on. On the other hand, though, this is also incredibly useful because it really helps us saving memory, so we don't make unnecessary copies if we don't need them. I think explain that later. Here it is. Before we get to that, there's also a way we can manually create a copy when we need it. But let us briefly just stick with this example. So I mentioned that if we do use a simple indexing with an integer here, then this will create a memory view, and slicing will also create a memory view. So we can slice, use a slicing operation, and this will also create a memory view. It will even happen if we use, let's say, something, let's do it like that. So this will then also create a memory view. So every time we use a slicing operation, similar to using an integer as indexing value, it will always create a memory view. And the same applies to columns here. So column slicing, so here we are just using all the rows and we use an integer for the columns. So this will also create a memory view. Similarly, if I, let's say, want the last column, let's do 2, 2, 3. This will also be a slicing operation now, and this will, similar to 2, create a memory view. So yeah, the takeaway here is that slicing creates views. However, if we wanted to, we can create copies. So that's what I'm demonstrating here. So we can create a copy of an array by, or values in an array by just calling .copy. So in this case, I'm creating a copy of the second row. I can also just do the first row, but I mean, why not? It's maybe less confusing to compared to switching between rows. So now this one will be unmodified. See, so we used copy, so this one first row will be modified, so this will be incremented by 99 like before, but the original array will be unaffected. Now this memory view concept applied to using integer indexing commands and using slicing. However, there's a concept in NumPy, it's called fancy indexing, where fancy indexing creates copies of an array, not views. And yeah, this can be maybe a little bit confusing because it's not the indexing by itself that creates views, it's just the integer indexing and the slicing that creates views, and the fancy indexing creates copies. So what is fancy indexing? So fancy indexing, it's a fancy name for a relatively simple concept. It's just using multiple integer indices. So why it's called fancy indexing, I think, is because it's something you can't do in Python. So let's say I have, or regular Python outside NumPy. So if I have a list like that in Python, I can do slicing. So I can do, let's say, 2 to 5, that will work. And I can just use a simple integer here, but I can't do anything like, let's say, returning two values. Let's say I want the first value and the third value. That doesn't work. Similarly, I can also, if you think this is like a wrong notation, this one will also not work if I use square brackets inside. So in Python, in regular Pythonists, this type of indexing is not supported. So if I want the value 0, so the first value at the first position, at position index 0, and the position index 2, which would be the third number, this doesn't work. However, NumPy allows us to do that. So here, so if this was a NumPy array, let's just do this, NumPy array, this would actually work now. So this would be called fancy indexing because it's something that, something that Python would not allow us to do. So this is called fancy indexing. So we use this one as our two numbers. So it's a list of two numbers which will be indexing, referring to the index 0 and 2, so the first and third number. And similarly, if we have a two-dimensional array, we can also use the same fancy indexing way for the columns. So we can use this one to return the first column and the third column. However, note that fancy indexing will return a copy of the array, not a view, which we can demonstrate by, again, adding our favorite number, 99, to the array after fancy indexing. So here we will create a copy. So recall, 0 and 2 will be returning the first and third column, and you can see they are not modified. So, I mean, this copy will be modified, but the original array won't be modified. The original array is that one, because fancy indexing creates a copy. And it may be a little bit weird why NumPy is doing that, and it's related to efficiency reasons. Recall from the introduction to NumPy, the first video, I talked about caching and things like that. So if you have a slice, you can easily cache some values of the array in memory. It's kind of an efficiency thing. However, with a fancy indexing, there's right now no implementation to cache these values into a single array. So you can maybe think of it like that. If I have an array where I do a slicing like that, I can just take out this one as a view. However, if I have a fancy indexing where I may have the first value and the last value, I would have to create a new array, right? Because I can't just by slicing take out this one, this doesn't work. I would have to go in there and modify this one if I want fancy indexing with the first and third element. And this one would be a new array because this is not contained in this one here. So in that way, the fancy indexing and the copying, making a copy of the array, is just a consequence of how we work with the array. We don't take out a chunk here. We really take out individual values with fancy indexing and then patching them together. Of course, I mean, you can do something like that, where you have all three columns, which will be exactly copying the whole array, basically, right? However, still, because it's kind of like a syntax thing, fancy indexing by default is just behaving differently the way it's implemented. It's not auto-guessing. It's not going in there and saying, oh, you want column 0, 1, 2. Coincidentally, this is all the columns in the array, so I could actually do slicing instead of the fancy indexing. So NumPy is not doing that. It's kind of, if it's fancy indexing, it's regarding it as fancy indexing, and it behaves always the same as doing the copy. And in that way, the only things you really have to remember is slicing and integer-based indexing will create memory views, and fancy indexing will create copies of the array. Is the last example related to the fancy indexing that I used above. So above I returned the first two columns. The first and the third column. And here I'm returning third and the first column. So I'm kind of reversing it, which is another cool thing about fancy indexing. So it allows you to shuffle things. So here I'm shuffling this array here. So I can then this is again a copy. Let's just call it CP and then CP plus 99. And then I can just do plus equals the same thing. And then if I return array, it's still unaffected. It's still creating this copy. The aspect that I wanted to show here is that we can rearrange the order of the columns too with fancy indexing. It can be useful sometimes if we want particular columns and we want to shuffle the order of the columns. Another thing that we often do in practice, or at least I will show you some examples during the class when we implement machine learning algorithms, is using Boolean masks. So Boolean masks are just masks of containing true and false values. In Python, true and false, remember, are called Boolean, Booleans. So this is a type, a data type Boolean. So I think if you do type this, it should actually show you bool or something. Yeah. So it's a Boolean data type, and we can use masks to find certain values in an array and then use the mask to select values from an array. So for example, I can create a mask and say greater than 3 here. So it will return a mask that has the same shape as this original array, but all the values corresponding to which are greater than 3 will have a true value, and all the values smaller or equal to 3 will have a false value. So it will look like this. So it will have false, 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 true, true, true. And then I can actually use that mask to select values. So I may have a second array. I mean, this is a very simple example, so I don't have a second array, but you may have a corresponding array, and then you can select using this mask. So I can use this true, 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 false, false, false mask to select actually these values. So it's basically a two-step process to select individual values from an array. And this will also create a copy. It's similar to fancy indexing. It's just a special case of fancy indexing. Yeah, what's cool also about these masks and selection operations is that you can chain them. So you can use a logical or a logical AND to chain them together. So in this case, I will create a mask that will be values greater than 3 in the array, and the values will be divisible by 2. So it will be actually values greater than 3, so I only would consider these, and then divisible by 2. This would be then this one, right, and this one. So it will return 4 and 6. So this will be, of course, just the mask, and then I can use the mask to select the values 4 and 6. And yeah, that is what I wanted to say about fancy indexing, memory views, and memory copies. Yeah, so remember, Fancy indexing will return copies of the array, and integer-based indexing and slicing will create memory views. Both are useful. It's just a matter of knowing which does what, and then you will be actually fine when you use NumPy in practice.